I'm Marta Bloom with our special guest host from Reach Me Sports, Frankie the Bartender.
Thank you, Marta, and it's great to be here. Welcome back to Hollywood on Top.
From Little Shop of Horrors to center stage on the hit comedy Martin, to the mom with an iron fist on Everybody Hates Chris. She sets the room on fire with her talent and comedic wit.
From Glory to Sister Sister, Moesha, ER, and Monk, he's made primetime his home.
Now we are here to celebrate, and I do mean celebrate, their hit show, Survivor's Remorse, which is entering its fourth season on Stars, and boy, do we love this show.
Yes, the Calloways are back. Please welcome to the stage Tichina Arnold and Ronreaco Lee.
Thank you.
Hello, beautiful. Mwah, mwah, mwah. Yes, got it.
Got it?
How are
just
you?
One, just one.
Yeah, one for you.
Yeah, okay. I can do this all day.
Good to see you.
Yes, thank you, thank you.
Good to see me.
All right. All right, all right. Make yourselves comfortable.
Okay, I'm jealous of your shoes.
Oh, thank you. I'm jealous of your whole look, the outfit, the lashes, the hair, everything.
Thank you. I said that so you could tell me that.
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay, and we didn't rehearse. So before we get to the show, let's talk about some other celebrations. So I'm going to ask you all to please stand up. Cupcake, please. Thank you.
Tichina, from all of us here on Reach Me TV, we'd like to congratulate you on your 25th anniversary of Martin. Now, we all grew up watching the show, and let me tell you, you stole them all. And we're giving you our Red Velvet Cupcake Award for most outstanding performance in an on-camera series.
Thank you! I'm rubbing on my booty.
Oh. It's good for the skin.
Wait, 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 wait. There's more. The mango, please.
Ooh, I'll take this one. Thank you.
Ronreaco and Tichina, we would like to present you both with this Mango Mousse Cake Award for making it to the fourth season and hopefully many, many more.
Yes, yes, great. Yes, yes. Thank you. You gotta share.
So, down to business. What everybody wants to know is the diner scene at the end of season three. We need to get into it, we need to talk about it. It's one of the most intense scenes I have ever seen. And you know, just the decision to punctuate the season like that, and where does your character go in terms of the relationship with your father in season four?
I kind of knew Reggie had a dark past. I just didn't know that it would be coming up at the end of that season. But no, it was...
It was intense.
It was. It took a minute to try to figure out how I would kind of, you know, connect the dots.
But you'll be surprised how many kids out there connect with that scene.
Let me tell you.
They get beat by their dads all the time.
In my in Facebook, IG, Twitter, in my DM after that show aired, when I tell you hundreds of messages, not just from young men that could relate, but also from mothers that had to deal with that issue in raising young men. Mm. So I got it from, you know, from two different sides. And, you know, I really was like, I don't even know how to respond to some of these. And so I got one just as recently, literally as last week. And I just, you know, did the best I could to respond and tell the young lady to keep pressing on. But nonetheless, you know, for season four, you know, Reggie is Reggie, and he made it clear how he felt about his father. So, you know, I don't know that we'll see that relationship kind of change in season four. I think it'd be great to see Reggie at some point forgive his dad. I think it would be healthy. I think it'd be good for him.
Yeah.
And hopefully that'll happen. Hopefully we'll get a run. Then, you know, we'll get, like you said, many seasons.
And
we'll get to see Reggie forgive his dad.
Yeah, I mean, it'll be powerful when it happens, if it happens. Right. I mean, the way you left it doesn't look like it will happen. But yeah, I mean, it'll
be
very powerful.
You can go either way right now. You can go either way.
Tichina, executive producer LeBron James and Cam Calloway sometimes feel like a young LeBron. How did you prepare for your role as a mother to the superstar? Did you channel his mom?
Actually, I did not. I made sure that I'm like, you know what? I'm not gonna insert any of his mother into this because it's not about his mother. You know, I wanna make sure I bring my relationship and my experiences as a mother to it. Like with any character I play, I always insert a little bit of myself into it so it can be realistic, but I never insert the actual people that I'm playing. I keep people's business private.